Hey there, you looking kinda cute. Please consider subscribing and check out our Patreon for more. Enjoy the video. Alyssa Fields was a gorgeous, smart, charming, and very girly woman. Once a man got close to her, he would start to be drawn in by her femininity. He wouldn't realize what had just happened until it was too late. Gary Thompson was a normal man of 30 years. He was divorced and had two kids with his ex-wife. They were on good terms. He was dating again, but none of his recent dates had led to anything serious. He went to a bar to look for women, but he wasn't having any luck. Just another Friday, until she showed up. Alyssa went into the club and went straight to the bar. Everyone there was looking at her. All the other women looked at her with envy. Alyssa walked up to Gary and asked, "Is this seat taken?" He told her, "No, please sit down," while making a big gesture with his arm. "Thank you, my name is Alyssa, what's yours?" "My name is Gary," he said, putting out his hand to shake. "I'm glad to meet you."
"Me too," said Alyssa.
"What are you drinking?"
"Gin and tonic. Can I buy you a drink?"
And so went a typical conversation at the bar between two people who didn't know each other. Alyssa was wearing a beautiful red dress. She wore just the right amount of makeup and had long red nails. Just above her shoulders, her hair was cut in a very neat way. Even in the dim light of the bar, it sparkled, blonde, smooth, and silky. Then her eyes came into view. They were gray-blue and seemed to cut right through your heart when you looked at them. Aside from how she looked, she moved with such ease and grace that it looked like she was floating instead of walking. She was fashionable. She had a certain air about her. She could light up the whole bar the way a movie star could light up the screen. But she only paid attention to Gary, and he was in heaven. He was talking to this beautiful creature. He fell in love right away. He spent the whole night with Alyssa drinking and dancing, and she was smiling the whole time. He knew her phone number and was going to remember it. Her face, her body, the way she walked and talked. It was all so great, and he would never forget it. He thought about her the whole day as he did things. He thought, "She would like me more if I was thinner." So he went on a diet right away. He got rid of his frozen pizzas and beer and put healthy food like vegetables, lean cuisine, juices, tofu, and a few bottles of wine in the fridge. When he put away the groceries, he thought, "If she comes over, I can't have the house looking like this." During the next few hours, he dusted, cleaned, vacuumed, washed the windows, and even cleaned under the couch cushions. Still not happy, he decided that something was missing from the room. Before the store closed at 10 p.m., he ran out again and bought two bouquets of flowers. He went home and put the flowers in vases from his wedding. They were gifts for the wedding, but since the divorce, they vases have been collecting dust. The flowers made the room brighter and made it smell clean. He decided that it was much better for her now, and he would keep trying to make the place look nice in the morning. He called her up, and they talked until the early morning hours. Gary would usually get up on Sundays, play 18 holes of golf, and then go to the bar to watch football with the guys. When he woke up this day, all he could think about was Alyssa. He ate a good breakfast and then ran for an hour. When he got home, he went outside to work in the garden, pulling out weeds, trimming, edging, and making the yard look good. He decided that he would plant more flowers and flowering bushes in the spring. That would make her happy. He took a shower and then saw how messy his bathroom was. He scrubbed and cleaned for the next 2 hours until it looked good. He talked about how he would feel bad if she came over and saw how bad it was. He put on his clothes and shook his head as he looked at the clothes in his closet. What did he think he was doing when he bought all these things? He went to the garage and got a big trash bag. Then he started taking clothes out to give to the poor. Baseball and football jerseys, t-shirts with logos from different sports, gray workout shirts that are plain. He'd never be able to wear them in front of her. Soon, he needed a second bag because he was giving away so many clothes. Gary took the clothes to a Salvation Army store and then went to the mall. He had to get a few things for his house. By the end of the day, his living room looked much better. Yes, Alyssa would like his house better now. At 10 o'clock, he called her and they talked for hours again. He asked her if they could hang out soon, and she seemed excited about the idea. Gary's heart was racing, and he couldn't wait to see her again.
Alyssa said she would meet Gary on Tuesday for dinner and maybe a movie afterward. Gary had just finished reading a review of a new restaurant in town that said it had a great wine list, healthy fish, and salad dishes, and a great atmosphere. Gary took a shower after work. He wondered what Alyssa would think of his hairy chest as he took a shower. He thought that if it was smooth, she would like him more. He shaved the hair off his shoulders, chest, and back of his neck. When he looked at the results, he decided that the hair in his armpits didn't go with the rest of his smooth chest. Off it went. When he was done, he would have to clean that up. Gary looked at his legs and thought, what a good plan, and shaved his legs too. Gary was happy with what he had done as he dried off with a towel after his shower. As he dressed, he couldn't help but feel like he wasn't good enough. Alyssa got to wear clothes that were so fun and nice. She wore skirts, blouses with low necklines, and wonderful shoes. Shirts and pants were all he had. It didn't seem right. Why did she buy all the nice clothes? He wished he had cool clothes like the ones she wore. He dried his hair with the blow dryer and stared at his face. It was just so boring. Alyssa wore light makeup that made her face look radiant and brought out the best parts of her face. He could go buy some to make himself look better for her. But unfortunately, he didn't have time. He had to hurry to get ready. He hadn't thought about how long it would take to shave. As Gary got dressed, he felt bad about his clothes, and again felt like he wasn't good enough because Alyssa got to wear much better clothes than he did. He was curious about what she'd wear tonight. He picked up his car keys and left. Gary showed up at the restaurant Alyssa had suggested at the time she said he would. When he got there, he went to the bar. She was there. His heart briefly stopped. She was so beautiful. He walked over, and when she smiled at him, he almost fell over. He was actually weak all over. After all the waiting, he was so happy to finally be with her. Alyssa was holding a white beeper from the restaurant. It started to beep and flash. She said, "That's us, hun." They got up and followed the young woman who was setting them up to the table. They sat down, and Alyssa ordered a bottle of wine for dinner while they chatted. She wore a white blouse, a long black skirt with a slit down the side, and sensible flats. Gary had to pinch himself to be sure he wasn't dreaming. They stopped talking about work and started talking about other things. Since they were still getting to know each other, they were a little cautious in their talk. Gary didn't want to talk about politics or anything else that could offend her or scare her away so soon in what he was sure would be a long-term relationship. As any woman would be on a first date, Alyssa was being careful. Gary chose the Greek salad for dinner, while Alyssa chose the Caesar salad. He wanted to show her that he ate well to win her over. On the other hand, he didn't really want a big steak anyway. It was usually his favorite, but he didn't want to eat it tonight for no reason, so salad it was. He paid close attention to her as she talked, watching how her hair moved, how her lips moved, and how her eyes flashed. He was so interested that he didn't eat much. When he realized that the meal was almost over, he started to think about how he could spend more time with her. She told him, "Gary, I've had a wonderful night," which made his heart jump. He tried not to sound too eager when he said, "Me too." It didn't work. Alyssa said, "I'd love to do this with you again sometime and get to know you better. I have to get up early for work tomorrow, though, so I'll have to take a pass on the movie." Gary felt like a 10-ton weight had been dropped on him. So soon she was going to leave? He gasped for air and struggled to find the right words. Alyssa saw that he was upset and told him not to worry. "Don't worry, hon. I'm not breaking up with you. How about you come over to my place for one quick drink and then we'll call it a night?" He asked her for her address and he drove to her house to meet her. Gary gasped when he got inside and looked around like he was in an art museum. He paid close attention to how she put the furniture and decorations together and how her tastes showed in everything from the wine on the rack in the kitchen to the kinds of flowers she had in her yard. Inside, Gary promised that he would change his house so that it looked more like hers. Her home was just right. They drank a Chardonnay that tasted like fruit and talked some more. Gary didn't drink much because he still had to drive home. Gary got along with her better than he had with any other woman. She had to be the right person. With other women, there seemed to be a space between them that made it hard for them to talk. But when it came to Alyssa, he knew exactly what she meant. He found it easy to wait until it was his turn to talk before interrupting her. When women talk, most men cut them off, which makes them angry because they don't feel like they are being heard or really listened to. Gary had done that too many times in the past, just like most men. He didn't even know it at the time. But now, for some reason, it was easy for him to talk to a woman the way a woman would. When the delicious wine was gone, Gary took the glasses back to the kitchen to rinse them out before putting them in the dishwasher. When he got back to the living room, they started saying their goodbyes. When he finally got to the front door, he almost fell over a full plastic bag. "Oh, I'm so sorry," said Alyssa. "That's my dry clean clothes. I didn't have time to take them in today, so I left them there so they wouldn't get wet in the car." "That's fine," insisted Gary. "I'm fine. Actually, I have to take my dry cleaning in tomorrow. Here, let me save you a trip. I'll take yours in too." Gary was proud that he was going to do something nice for her and that she would think more of him, even though he had almost tripped over her clothes bag. Alyssa gave Gary a small hug as a final farewell. "Feel free to try on the clothes if you want," Alyssa joked. Wait, did she know he was interested in cross-dressing? Gary never actually tried on girl clothes before, but was very interested. "Maybe I will," he joked and then drove home. Thanks for watching. Check out Patreon if you want to have early access to the other parts. If not, it will be online in a couple of days.